إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد إخوتي في الله يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الناس أو mankind إن وعد الله حق The promise of Allah is true فلا تغرنكم الحياة الدنيا Don't be fooled by the life of this world Don't be fooled by the dunya ولا يغرنكم بالله الغرور And don't be fooled by the biggest deceiver, الشيطان نعم يا عباد الله نحن نقبل على الدنيا ولعل بعضنا لا نعلم ما قدم الأولون من الدماء والعرق والجهود في نشر الإسلام We enjoy ourselves in the life of this world and perhaps many of us don't know what our Salaf al-Salih and the righteous before us did in spilling their blood and their sweat and their hard work and spreading Islam. يقول نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جاء عن كعب ابن عياض لكل أمة فتنة وفتنة أمتي المال Every ummah, every nation has a test and has a fitna, and the test of my ummah, of my nation, is money. نعم يا عباد الله منا من ينعم ويتمتع نعم يا عباد الله على دماء الأولين والعرق نعم والجهود الذي بذلوها Amongst us, or all of us, we comfort ourselves and we live in luxury from the spread of Islam and from the honor of Islam. Na'tez bidinina. We are honored with the ni'mah of Islam. But we don't know what the blood that was spilt and the sweat that was spilt and the hard work that was spilt so that we can have this deen. I'lam ya Abdullah, anna tark ad-dunya huwa sabab intishar ad-deen. That leaving off the dunya and abandoning the dunya is the reason why Islam spread. Wal iqbal ala dunya the habud deen. And advancing and chasing dunya is the reason for the deen to go away. Let's look at those that preceded us. Na'am ya ibadallah. Ja'a fi sahih. An Abdurrahman bin Auf. Utiya bi ta'amin wa kana sa'iman. Abdurrahman ibn Auf radiallahu anhu, he was given some food and he was fasting. When he was given the food to break his fast, فَقَالَ قُتِلَ مُصْعَبْ ibn Umair وَكَانَ خَيْرٌ مِنِّي مُصْعَبْ ibn Umair, he was killed and he was better than me. تَرَكَ بَرْدَةٍ كُفِنَ فِي بَرْدَةٍ He was shrouded. His kafan was just a barda. I mean, just a rida, just a scarf. إِنْ غُطِّيَ رَأْسُهُ بَدَى رِجْلًا If we covered his head with it, his feet came exposed. وَإِنْ غُطِّيَ رِجْلَاهُ بَدَى رَأْسُهُ And if we covered his feet, His head exposed. His head was exposed. Thumma busitat lana min ad-dunya ma busitat. And then after those hard days, the dunya was opened up for what it opened up for us. Wa u'tina min ad-dunya ma u'tina. And we were given from the dunya that which we were given. Wa qad khashina an takuna hasanatuna qad ujjilat lana faja'ala yabki hatta taraka at-ta'am. He said, and we are afraid that our good deeds and reward that we're supposed to get in the hereafter, it was hastened for us. It was given for us in this world until he started crying and he left off the food. He'd even break his fast. Na'am ya ibadallah. Al-awwalun ta'ibu min ajli nashriddin. Taraku ad-dunya min ajlikum. Those that came before us, they left off the dunya, so that Islam could spread, so that it could reach you and your family and in your lands. Ja'a mithl dhalika an Khabbab ibn Urat radiyallahu anhu fa sahi qala hajarna ma'a Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam naltamisu wajha Allah. We made hijrah, we immigrated with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, seeking the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَوَقَعَ أَجْرُنَا عَلَى اللَّهِ. So our reward, it fell on Allah. We only got what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us. فَقَالَ وَمِنَّا مَنْ مَاتْ وَلَمْ يَأْكُلْ مِنْ أَجْرِهِ شَيْئًا. From amongst us are those who died, they didn't eat anything. They didn't take anything from their reward. Minhum Mus'ab ibn Umair radiyallahu anhum. Radiyallahu anhu. From amongst them was Mus'ab ibn Umair radiyallahu anhu. Qutila yawm Uhudin wa taraka namira. He was killed yawm Uhud. In the battle of Uhud, he just left a piece of cloth. In ghattayna bihi ra'sah bada rijlah. If we covered his head, his feet were exposed. When ghattayna bihi rijlahi bada ra'sah. And if we covered his feet, his head was exposed. Fa amarana Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an nughattiya ra'sah wa naj'ala rijlahi shay'an min al-idhkhir. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he commanded us to cover his head, and to make over his feet in the grave some leaves and some bushes and some branches. وَمِنَّا مَنْ عَيْنَعَتْ لَهُ ثَمَرَتُهُ وَهُوَ يَهْدِبُهَا. أي مِنَّا مَنْ ثَمَرَتُهُ أَصْبَحَ نَاضِجْ يَانِعْ وَهُوَ يَسْتَفِيدُ مِنْهَا. And from amongst us, the fruits of this world have ripened for him, have become ripe for him, and he benefits from it. Na'am ya ibadallah. Ja'a fi sahih min hadithi Utbah ibn Ghazwan annahu khataba wa qala laqad ra'aytuni sabi'a sab'atin ma'a rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ma lana ta'amun illa waraq ash-shajar hatta qadihat ashdaquna. He said, I saw myself, I was the seventh person with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We had no food except the leaves off of trees, and we ate that until the corners of our mouths had sores in it. Na'am ya ibadallah. Fattaqattu bi barda. I found a piece of cloth, a barda, a piece of material. Fashaqaqtuha bayni wa bayni Sa'd ibn Ubadah. So I split it in half between me and Sa'd ibn Ubadah. فَاتَّذَرْتُ بِنِصْفِهَا وَاتَّذَرَ بِنِفْسِي. I took half of it and wore it as a izar. And he took the other half and he wore it as a izar. فَمَا أَصْبَحَ الْيَوْمَ مِنَّا أَحَدٌ إِلَّا أَصْبَحَ أَمِيرٌ عَلَى مِصْرٍ مِنَ الْأَمْصَارِ. He said, as for today, then there's nobody from amongst us except he became Amir, a leader of a country from the other countries. وَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ أَنْ أَكُونَ فِي نَفْسِي عَظِيمًا وَإِنْدَ اللَّهِ صَغِيرًا. And I seek refuge from Allah that with myself I'm great and I'm established, and with Allah I'm small and nothing. نَعَمْ يَا عِبَادَ اللَّهِ تَرَى نَفْسَكَ عَظِيمًا تَرَى أَنَّكَ كَسَبْتَ كَثِيرًا تَرَى أَنَّكَ بَطَلًا. You see that you're important and that you're big انتبه أن تكون عند الله صغيرا. Be careful that with Allah you're small and you're not considered. نعم يا عباد الله. قال أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه ونحن نعلم شأن أبي هريرة. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he said, and we know who Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu is in his position. وَالَّذِي نَفْسِي بِيَدِهِ وَالَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ. I swear by the one that nothing is worthy of worship except him. إِن كُنْتُ لَأَعْتَمِدُ بِكَبِدِي عَلَى الْأَرْضِ مِنَ الْجُوعِ وَإِن كُنْتُ لَأَشُدُّ الْحَجْرَ عَلَى الْبَطْنِ مِنَ الْجُوعِ. I used to lay on the floor and press my stomach on the floor because of hunger. Wallahi, I used to tie a rock on my stomach because of jua', because of hunger. Na'am ya ibadullah. Qala Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, laqad ra'aytuni. I saw myself akhirru fi ma bayna minbari Rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa hijrati Aisha maqshiyan alayya. I saw myself, I would fall down and faint and be knocked out between the minbar of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the house of Aisha in the masjid radiallahu anha, fainted, falling out in the masjid. فَيَجِئُ جَائِي فَيَضَعَ رِجْلَهُ عَنَ عُنِقِي يَرَى أَنِّي مَجْنُونَ مَا بِي مِن جُنُونَ مَا بِي إِلَّا الْجُوعَ ما بي إلا الجوع. نعم يا عباد الله. He says, so somebody would come and he would put his foot on my neck. He would think that I'm insane. He would think that I'm mentally ill. I have no insanity with me. It's just that I'm hungry. It's just that I'm starving. نعم يا عباد الله. حاولاهم الأولون تركوا الدنيا من أجلنا. They left off the dunya so that Islam could reach our lands. نعم يا عباد الله. وصل إلى اليمن. وصل إلى الهند. وصل إلى باكستان. وصل إلى أماكن قربا وشرقا. East and west. شمالا وجنوبا. South and north. نعم يا عباد الله. بالدماء وبالعرق وبالجهود. With their blood. In their sweat. In their hard work. جاء عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله عنه كما أخرجه الإمام الترمذي نام رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم على حصير فقام قد أثر في جنبه. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he fell asleep on a straw mat. So when he stood up, أثر في جنبه, it left marks on his skin and on his body. فقلنا يا رسول الله لو اتخذنا لك وطاعا أي فراشا. When he stood up and the people saw these marks on the Prophet, they said, oh Messenger of Allah, why don't we buy for you a mattress or something soft? فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم مالي وللدنيا مالي وللدنيا. What do I have to do with this dunya? What connection do I have with this dunya? Ma ana fi dunya illa karakiban istadhalla tahta shajaratin istadhalla tahta shajaratin thumma rah wa tarakaha. I have nothing to do with this dunya and the life of this world except as a traveler who traveled. He stopped under a tree just to get a little shade. Then he went and he left it. And he left this dunya. نعم يا عباد الله هكذا كان الأولون تركوا الدنيا. الإقبال على الدنيا هو ذهاب الدين. Those before us, they left off the dunya. Know that embarkment upon the dunya هو ذهاب الدين. That makes the deen go away. Knowledge go away. Salawat go away. أعمال الصالحات go away. نعم يا عباد الله. جاء في الصحيح أن نعمان بن بشير رضي الله عنه أن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه ذكر ما أصاب الناس من الدنيا. نعمان بن بشير, he said that one day عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه, he mentioned what fell on the people and what occurred to the people and what came to them from worldly affairs and from wealth. وقال لقد رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يظل اليوم يلتوي ما يجد من الدقل ما يملأ به بطنه والدقل هو تمر الردي. نعم يا عباد الله. Umar ibn Khattab, he said, I saw the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would spend the whole day going left and right. He would not find from the worst of tamar, from the worst of dates, to fill up his stomach. Na'am ya ibadallah. Qala Muhammad ibn Sirin, anna Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, marra biqawmin bayna aydihim, shatan masliyah. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he passed by a people that had in front of them a sheep that they were roasting. Fada'ahu, they invited him to eat with them. Fa'aba an ya'kul, he refused to eat that food. Qala, mata Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa lam yashba' min khubz al-sha'ir, arda khubz. Na'am ya ibadallah, he refused to eat that food. He said the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died and he never got satisfied and full of khubz min barley, which is the worst of khubz. Famal hal ya ibadallah? What is the solution, O brothers in Islam? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, badiru bil a'mal, rush to do good deeds. Fitanan qaqita' al-layl al-muzlim. Fitan is going to come, is going to cover us just like the night covers the whole day. يصبح الرجل مسلما ويمسي كافرا. A man's going to enter the day, he's Muslim, by the night he's kafir. ويمسي مسلما ويصبح كافرا. He enters into the night, he's Muslim, by the day he's kafir. يبيع دينه بأرض من الدنيا القليل. He sells his religion for something small from the dunya. His lady leaves off his salah. He leaves off يوم الجمعة. She leaves off her hijab for something from the dunya, al-qaleel, that's insignificant. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his aid and his mercy. Alhamdulillah. Hamdun kathiran tayyiban mubarakan fi kama yuhibbu rabbuna wa yarda. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. عباد الله، الحرص على المال إذا تمكن في القلب بقي مع صاحبه إلى القبر. الحرص، إيجنس على الدنيا، إيجنس، نعم، anxiousness to get money, if it becomes firm in the heart, it stays with the person until he dies. وَهَذَا مَعْنَى قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرُ. And that's the meaning of Allah's statement where he says, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. It has preoccupied you, competing one another for the dunya. التَّكَاثُرُ. كل واحد يريد أن يتكاثر ويزيد على صاحبه. Competing to get more, competing to get more has preoccupied you حتى زرتم المقابر, until you visit your grave. That hirs and that anxiousness is going to be with you until you enter your grave. فانتبه أيها الفطن. So be careful. You're intelligent, right? You understand, right? Be careful. احرص على نفسك. Be anxious on yourself. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يبين هذا. فقال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما جاء في الصحيح عن أبي هريرة. لو كان لابن آدم واد من الذهب لأحب أن يكون له واديان ولن يملأ فاه إلا التراب. وَلَنْ يَمْلَأْ فَاهُ إِلَّا التُّرَابُ وَيَتُوبُ اللَّهُ عَلَى مَنْ تَابُ. أي هذا الانهماك والإقبال يحتاج توبة. نعم يا عباد الله. If Ibn Adam, mankind, if he was given a valley of gold, He would want and wish that he had 2 valuables of gold. And his mouth would not be filled except with the dirt. And he's going to have this desire until he gets in his grave. And the grave fills his mouth up with dirt. Well, yatubullahu ala man yatab. And Allah accepts the repentance of those who repent. Meaning this advancement upon dunya, it demands repentance. Na'am ya ibadallah. Ja'a inda al-imam Ahmad min hadithi Anas radiyallahu anhu. And the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, yahrumu ibn Adam wa tabqa fihi ithnan. Yahrum, ay yakbur fi sin. Yahrumu ibn Adam wa tabqa fihi ithnan. Al-hirsu wal-amal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ibn Adam, he becomes elderly and he becomes old. His bones become feeble and he becomes weak. But 2 things inside of him remains young and strong. Al-hirs wal-amal, his eagerness for money. And he has her loyal wishes that he's going to live long. He's going to have all these desires. Na'am ya ibadallah. Wa ja'a mithluhu fi sahihi Muslim. An Anasin kathalik. And the Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, يهرم ابن آدم وتشب فيه اثنان أي تكون فيه شباب أمران. Mankind, he becomes elderly and gray and weak. وتشب فيه اثنان. 2 things in him is young and vibrant. الحرص على المال والحرص على العمر. His desire to get more money and his desire to have a long life, no matter how old he gets, no matter how feeble he gets, if hirs ala dunya huwa fil qalb, yabqa ma'a sahibihi ila al-qabr. If love for the dunya has it firmly entered in somebody's heart, it's going to stay with him until he enters his grave. فلذلك كان النبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول كما جاء أصله في مسلم عن زيد بن أرقم وجاء عند الإمام أحمد والترمذي وغيره عن أنس وعن عبد الله بن عمرو بن عاص اللهم إني أعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع وقلب لا يخشع ونفس لا تشبع ودعاء لا يسمع أعوذ بك الله من هؤلاء الأربع ومنها نفس لا تشبع. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, from his dua he used to say, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa'. I seek refuge from knowledge that doesn't benefit. I get the knowledge from the Quran and the Sunnah, I don't work with it. Wa qalbin la yakhsha. A heart is not affected by the Quran and that which comes from Allah. Wa nafsin la tashba. And the nafs is never satisfied. No matter how much Allah gives it, it's never satisfied. Well, because all of that, dua in la yusma. And the dua is not answered. أعوذ بك الله من هؤلاء الأربع. I seek refuge in you and Allah from these 4 things. الحرص على المال يذهب الدين. Eagerness for dunya, the deen goes away. We're about to enter Ramadan. ما من رمضان ونحن ندور من يصلي بنا كم حافظ للقرآن في بيتك. Come have a little Quran fi usratik ayyuhal kareem. Every Ramadan, we are looking, who's going to lead us in salah in Ramadan? How many people in your family memorize Quran? Come anta turabbi li hafdil Quran. Come anta turabbi fi baytik min ajli deen. How many people in your family memorize Quran? How many people you teach to memorize in your Quran? Rabbu rajulin yurabbi waladahu hatta yakunu tamma'an. Jama'an, manna'an, wa'iyadu billah. Some of us, we raise our children so he could just desire dunya. And he could gather it up and refuse to give it anybody. Sahib dunya. We want to raise up somebody who can gather money. That's what we want to raise up. Ya asafan ala al-ibad. What a disappointing thing it is on the servants of Allah. John Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما ذئبان جائعان أرسلا على غنم بأفسد لها من حرص المرء على المال والشرف لدينه. أي حرص المرء على المال والشرف أشد فساد من ذئبين جائعين على غنم. نعم يا عباد الله. There are no two hungry wolves that have been sent on a pack of sheep. No two hungry wolves is more corrupting than a man who's eager for money and fame on his religion. That's more damaging. فشبه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ذئبين جائعين بالحرص على المال والشرف. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he made a resemblance between two hungry wolves and desiring money and desiring fame. وما وشبه الغنم بالدين, and he compared غنم, sheep, with the religion. وما عسى أن يفعل ذئبان جائعان بالغنم إلا أن يشوه ظاهرها ويمزق ويقطع باطنها. What is two sheep? What is two wolves going to do to a group of sheep? I said they're going to destroy the face of it, and they're going to rip up, and they're going to cut up inside of it. وَحَاكَذَا حِرْصُ عَلَى الدُّنْيَا بِدِينِنَا. And that's what chasing dunya does on our religion. نعم يا عباد الله. قال أبو الدرداء رضي الله عنه كما أخرج ابن ماجة رضي رحمه الله, دخل علينا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ونحن نذكر الفقر ونتخوفه, فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الفقر تخافون, الفقر تخافون. يا سبحان الله. أبو الدرداء رضي الله عنه, he said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he entered upon this and we were talking about poverty and we were afraid of when we were talking about poverty. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, is it poverty that you are all afraid of? والذي نفسي بيدي لا تصبن عليكم الدنيا صبا حتى لا يزيغ قلب أحد منكم إزاغة إلا هي. The dunya is going to pour upon you a pouring until the point that nothing is going to turn one of your hearts astray except dunya. يا عباد الله. أتخافون الفقر? Are you afraid of poverty? أجدادنا صبروا عليها. سلفنا, they were patient upon dunya. فضلوها. They preferred it. من أجلنا. For the sake of us. إي والله. فعملوا الخير. بادروا بالأعمال. أين حفاظ كتاب الله? من سيصلي بنا? من سيخطبنا? من تربي في بيتك? Where are you raising up in your house? من يحفظ قرآن في بيتك? من يتعلم دين في بيتك? ممكن نساء مجموعة لا يقرأنا حروف العربية. Maybe somebody has in their house women that don't even read Quran. They don't even know how to read. ما يعرفنا من إسلام شيئا. His women don't know anything about Islam. في الأخير جاء عن عمرو بن عوف الأنصاري, بعث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أبا عبيدة ابن جراح إلى البحرين يأتي بجزيتها. أبو عبيدة رضي الله عنه, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم sent him to Bahrain to come with the jizya, the money that he takes from the disbelievers. فقدم بمال من البحرين. So he came to Medina with money that he got from Bahrain. وسمعت الأنصار بقدوم يا أبي عبيدة. For the Ansar, they heard that Abu Ubaidah came with some money from Bahrain. فوافوا صلاة الفجر مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. So they all came together and they made صلاة الفجر with the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم. فلما صلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وانصرف تأرضوا له. So when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made Fajr and then he turned around, they came and they sat in front of him. فَتَبَسَّمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he smiled and he said, أَظُنُّكُمْ سَمِعْتُمْ أَنَا أَبَا أُبَيْدَى قَدِمَ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْبَحْرَيْنِ قَالُوا أَجَلْ. Prophet said, I think you all heard that Abu Ubaida, he came with something from Bahrain. They said, yes. قَالَ أَبْشِرُوا وَأَمِّلُوا مَا يَسُرُّكُمْ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, rejoice and continue hoping for that which you want. For wallahi mal faqru akhsha alaykum. I swear by Allah, it's not poverty that I fear for you all. وَلَكِنِّي أَخْشَىٰ أَن تُبْسَطَ عَلَيْكُمُ الدُّنْيَا كَمَا بُسِطَتْ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِن قَبْلِكُمْ. I fear that the dunya is going to be opened up for you all, just like it opened up for those before you. فَتَنَافَسُوهَا كَمَا تَنَافَسُوهَا. And you all chasing can be for it, just as they chased and competed for it. فَتُحْلِكَكُمْ كَمَا أَهْلَكَتْهُمْ. And it will destroy you, just as it destroyed them. Nasrallah subhanahu wa ta'ala al-afiyah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for afiyah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us muqbilin ala al-khayr. Nasrallah subhanahu wa ta'ala make of those who enter upon khayr. Ya ikhwati billah, nahnu nahtaj rijal. We have to raise up men. We have to raise up rijal al-deen. We say here in America, over there in that state, there's a brother that memorized Quran. Over there in that state over there, there's a brother who knows Arabic. There's a brother over there that can read Quran. Ya subhanallah, law alima ajdaduna ma nahnu fi labakaw alayna. If our salaf, they knew that they, what we were in, they would cry over us. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ya'inina jameena ala ta'ati. Innahu waliyu dhalik wal qadir alayhi. وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.